Okay, so what I'm going to do today is take these out, my new Nike sneakers for a run.
So the GPS is ready, the sneakers are on, let's give it a go. One thing to remember is that the prime knit upper is very flexible, so it takes a few miles for the feet to get ready. Uneven surfaces are not good for the sole. Mentioned that it's a mile uphill into the wind and the feet are starting to ache a bit without flying it up. So have a look around. We've got this hill, 1 mile up to the head, and the outer foot is going to start to ache a bit. Okay, that's the top of the hill. As I said, it takes about 2 miles for the foot muscles to get used to that lack of a midsole. Okay, so we now turn the corner from the hill. Road Max is doing well, and we're going to see the benefits of running in the British countryside. Cool. So I'll open up a bit now, get my pace down to 9 minutes. Certainly feel the nodules working on the outside of the feet. So we're coming up to the 2 mile mark now, and the feet are stepping, starting to wear in. The muscles are starting to work and it hurts a lot less. Working well. 2 miles, going to test this little chicane here. See what the lockdown's like. It's okay. So coming up to crossing this busy road here. Takes a little while. VaporMax is holding up well. Down it all the way to the back. So this is where the VaporMax is coming to their own. Slight downhill, totally flat surface. It really does feel like we're running on air. It's like we are days. So now I got the speed up nicely to sub 8 minute mile. The VaporMax is bouncing. Gorgeous terrain. It's going to be ready for a 6 million dollar man montage. Okay, well, the last quarter of a mile. I'm wondering whether the air heats up because it certainly works better later than earlier. Much, much better. Okay, time for the last 100 meter sprint. Let's go.
Okay, that's it, done. What do I think? After the first 2 miles, love them. Before that, need some breaking in. Thank you.